Peace, everybody. This is Queen Ifama. I am the Truth Terrorist, and I am doing my lunchtime video. This is like the third attempt because battery went down, so I had to do it over. And I'm also working on a project, so bear with me if I'm not looking directly in the camera. Just to show y'all what I'm doing, I'm making a cord for a necklace that I'm making. Okay? So it's a red, black, and green cord, and I'm using a kumi loom to weave the cord. So this is the cord right here. This is how it's going to look. It's going to be kind of, you know, like that. Anyway, I'm going to have a pendant go to it. But anyway, I said I was going to do a video about the angry black woman because someone on my channel made a comment about me having the angry black woman syndrome. And I want to clarify for everyone that what they consider the angry black woman syndrome is not my anger. Because that anger basically is directed more than likely toward men. I'm not angry with men, okay? Black men in particular. And in my relationships with men, I take full responsibility for my ignorance in the relationship, okay? So, you know, I'm not mad at past boyfriends and all that other kind of shit. I mean, I'm just not, because, you know, I had a hand in that shit too. So I take responsibility for that. So my anger is not for that. My anger is definitely about the global condition, you know, because I look at a larger picture. So my anger is definitely about a larger picture. The world, you know, I look at women over in various countries who can't walk to get water in this country, can't even go to a store at night without being accosted. So my anger is directed toward that. I look at men who kill other brothers, and I mean, it's just a society, not a society, but a world society that's based on violence. And so I'm angry about the violence. I think that we perpetrate things that could definitely be stopped. We don't have to have violence. And, you know, I was thinking about, you know, a lot of people talked about this survival of the fittest. You know, like, well, you know what Charles Darwin talked about, the survival of the fittest. But I think when Charles Darwin was talking about the survival of the fittest, what I got out of that was he was talking about people's ability to adapt, not to conquer and take over and all that, but to be able to be adaptable to your environment. And that's the fittest. You know what I'm saying? So I don't think it was about this dominating force. I think it was more geared to your ability to adapt to your environment. As your environment changes, are you fit enough to survive, you know, and adapt to the environment? So, you know, my issue, my anger is directed, you know, toward things that I think that we have more control over, but we kind of succumb to our lower natures, our what I was saying on our show is our nature, you know, because a lot of us have different natures. And one of the things is you have to recognize what your nature is. And sometimes people are prone to jealousy. People are prone to hatred. People are prone. That's in their nature. Okay. I mean, it's just something in them. But at the same time, you have power to control your nature. And I think that's what all these religions and all of those things were created and designed for, is to help people have a tool to be able to control certain aspects of their natures, right, that are detrimental to the society. So, you know, my anger is definitely about the world in general, not gender specific or event specific. But it's more global in the things that I see that's happening in the world that I think we can change, you know, if we just have the mind to control our natures, okay? Because I think that's what's out of control. is that I think our natures are out of control, and we don't know how to control the negativity, the negative part of who we are, you know, for that matter. You know, you got ego problems, you got hate problems, you got lust problems, you have, you know, just a myriad of things that are, I think, natural for some of us that we have to really get a handle of. And that's what I'm angry about. You know, that's where my anger is. It lies. It lies in the fact that we could do better, and we just won't. We won't try. You know what I'm saying? We talk a bunch of shit, but we don't look within to change ourselves. We don't take honest inventory of who we are. And I just find that to be absolutely ludicrous, because I've always felt that I'm no one special. And I think that if I can do it, if I can look internally at myself and know who I am and what I am and what I'm capable of, and, you know, my nature, to understand my nature, and to, if it's negative, to do something about that, then, you know, I make the choice to do that. You know, now some aspects about myself that other people don't like, they that want me to change it, I'm not doing that. I don't change for other people. But I do recognize and know the bad things about myself that I have changed just for my own satisfaction. You know what I'm saying? Maybe it comes across to other people, but I'm like I said, you got the choice not to even deal with me. You know, that's your choice. You don't have to come to my channel. You don't have to come to my house. You don't have to come around me at all if you don't like me. Because I'm definitely not going to go around people that I don't like. I'm not going to go to channels of people that I don't like just to put negative comments on their channels. I'm not going to follow people on Twitter or Facebook that I really don't like. If I don't like you, I am not going to have anything to do with you. Okay, I'm not gonna come to your channel and talk about you or say I disagree with what you're saying. I don't like you, and I don't care what you say, and you are a non-factor to me. Okay, so these are things that I've learned to do, rather than to doggedly and houndlessly pursue people and try to change other people. I'm not in the convincing business. I keep telling people that, you know. And if you don't like me, I am cool with that. Just don't bother me if you don't. That's all I'm saying. Don't bother me. If you don't like what I'm saying, and you don't like me, you don't like how I look, you don't like how I speak, then don't come to my channel. It's just as simple as that. Or if you see me on the street, don't talk to me. Okay? I can take it. You know what I mean? I can take it and still smile at you, because I ain't got a problem with you. You the one got the problem with me. Okay? That's how I roll. You know what I mean? Most people hold all kind of animosity and stuff in their hearts. I don't do that. Once I say what I have to say with you, to you, I'm done with it. You know what I'm saying? I'm through with the whole situation. I don't have no feelings about you in my heart or anything like that. You're a non-factor. You know, you're not even important to me. You know what I'm saying? So this is what I find interesting about the YouTube environment, is that people have a tendency to come to the channels of people they don't like. Like, you got white people that don't like black people, but they're always coming to your channels making negative comments. And I'm like, why do you waste your time with people you don't even like? You know, or men who seek out women who are talking about issues that they have with men or whatever, they seek out these women's channels and they go and leave these negative comments on these women's channels. I'm like, why don't you just leave them alone? If you don't like them and you don't like what they talk about, then just leave them alone. Why are you trying to convince them otherwise? See, those are things that I don't understand about human nature that irritates me. It angers me, because you got a choice. You can move on. You can keep it moving. You know what I'm saying? But when you step to my channel and you leaving negative comments about me, I'm going to respond. Like a sister said, well, you know, you shouldn't waste your energy. That energy ain't wasted. I don't consider it wasted energy. I consider it well put energy, because I feel it's my nature to put your ass in check. You see what I'm saying? So I understand my nature perfectly. And like I said, I don't just spout off. I think about what I'm going to say. Every time I do a video, I think about how I'm going to phrase or address a certain situation. Okay, if I'm talking about something in particular, what I'm going to say about it, just like this video. Don't think I ain't thought about this. Every video I do, trust me, I think about it. So, you know, I thought long and hard about this video, and I incorporated a couple of comments as a jump-off point for my video. Three, as a matter of fact. And I think that, you know, when people really don't understand, you know, when I say I'm an angry black woman, that I'm not speaking of being angry with men. Fuck. Hell no, I ain't angry with men. I love men, you know. And even the ones that did me bad, man, or I did bad, because Lord knows I done did a man bad too. Trust me. And I think that my experiences with men is all about karma. You know, getting back what I put out long time ago. So, you know, I got to deal with that issue myself. You know what I'm saying? But, hey, I know that. And I think that, Lord knows, I think I paid. You know what I'm saying? I think I paid my debt, right? But anyway, just to clarify for everyone who saw the comment, because it did go to YouTube. Not YouTube, but Facebook too, that yes, I am an angry black woman. Please know that I am not one of those angry black women that are angry with black men, okay? Because I'm not. You know, that I've had bad experiences in my life with men. Well, damn, who ain't? Then broke up, got back together, broke up, went your other way. I mean, you know, I don't hold stuff in my heart. You know, for any guy that I've been with that I think done me wrong, you know, I just don't. Because, like I said from the gate, I made a decision to be with that man. And I'm going to tell you something. I ignored a lot of flags, you know, that when I look back now, that I let slide. This is going to be pretty, don't you think? I think that's going to be so pretty when I get done. But anyway. You know, I saw a lot of things that I let slide just because I wanted him. You know what I'm saying? I wanted someone. You know, so I take as much blame in failed relationships as, you know, I think the man should. 9 times out of 10, they don't. You know, they always blame me, you know, because I always leave. Why you leave? Well, damn, dude. You know, I couldn't take it no more. You know, I didn't want to take it no more. What I figured, you know, I figured this relationship was too much tumultuous. It was, you know, it was just too much energy that wasn't positive. So I ain't staying around positive energy. I gotta leave it alone. You know what I mean? So that's why, you know, I'm not angry about my relationships. I'm angry about things that are happening globally, things that are happening nationally, things that are happening locally that I think we have the power to control and change and make better. And we're just not putting forth enough effort collectively to do that. So that's what I'm angry about. So I hope that with this video that I have cleared up what I mean when I say that I am an angry black woman. I'm angry, I'm black, and I'm a woman. So I'm an angry black woman, okay? Not the stereotype, I'm not in a syndrome, okay? That syndrome, I'm not in the syndrome. I'm just an angry black woman, and I'm angry at global, national, local things that are happening that I know that we have the power to control. We can't control the weather. There are all kinds of catastrophes that happen naturally. Those things I'm not angry about, okay? Because then I'd be angry at the universe and the force that causes that, which is stupid, okay? But I'm angry at people who cause certain things outside of nature that are catastrophic, that harm other people. That's what I'm angry about, and we have control of that as human beings, as people. So that's where I'm angry. So I hope that I have clarified my position on the angry black woman that I am. I'm not speaking, you know, as a group representative of angry black women. I'm only speaking about me. Okay, so I hope that I cleared that up for any of the people out there who are, you know, wondering why are you an angry black woman? Well, now you know. Okay, now you know why I'm angry. Okay, so I put that on record for you. You got it on YouTube. It's going all out there. Now you don't have a question as to why I'm angry. Because if I'm angry at a man, trust me, he's specific. It ain't men in general, okay? It'd be one man that I'm angry at that particular time. But like I said, I don't stay angry long. Once I'm done with you, I'm done with you. I ain't still mad at you, okay? That goes with male or female. You know, but at a particular time, I will be angry. But I don't stay angry at an individual, okay? So, I hope y'all got it. You sure you got it? I hope so. Because I'm telling you the butt-naked truth. Yeah, I hope you understand that. So, all you other angry black women with the syndrome, I ain't in y'all group, okay? Even though I understand your anger as well, that's yours, okay? I'm not in the angry black woman syndrome group, okay? I don't have the t-shirt. And you know they got a t-shirt, too. And if I get a chance, if I can do this video, you know, within the allotted time, I might be able to find that t-shirt. But if you Google angry black woman, look here, let me tell you something. If you Google angry black woman, you go to images, Google has over 20-something images, 29, I think, of things that are related to the angry black woman. But if you put in angry white woman, I think it's about 14 related images to angry white woman. Okay. So this angry black woman thing is really like the taking off. I mean, it's just really so focused on. They got t-shirts, mugs, everything. I saw one little white t-shirt that said angry white girl. But for the angry black woman, she got a t-shirt, a mug, she got newspapers, books, all kind of stuff. Talking about her damn anger, okay? I don't want no book, and I don't want no t-shirt, and I don't want no mug saying nothing about I'm an angry black woman, because I can tell you I'm angry and tell you what I'm angry about, and it ain't got a damn thing to do with my black man. Not nothing to do with them, okay? So with that said, this is Queen Ifama. I am the Truth Terrorist. Peace, everybody, and I hope you have a good rest of your day. Bye.